name is Dezy and I am from 9th standard. Today I am teaching polynomials and factorization of polynomials. Before taking a look at polynomials, we will first study what is monomial, binomial and trinomial. We know that mono means one is a polynomial having only one term. Bi means two, means a polynomial having only two terms. Tri means three, whereas a polynomial having only three terms. And polynomials, poly means many. Polynomials is if the power of the variable is a whole number, then the algebraic expression is known as polynomial. They also contain real number and are known as constant. Just take a look at what is the degree of the polynomial. The highest power of the variable present in an algebraic expression. Now, this is the following example. And here are some terms present. And we have to take the look at the variable and know what is the highest power of the variable. You can see the highest power of the variable is 9. So, the degree of the polynomial is 9. Now, polynomials. So, our given example is x raised to 5 plus 4x 9 minus 5y square minus 9x cube plus 10y raised to 5. So, we take the highest powers and add them. So, the addition of the two highest terms is known as the degree of the polynomial. And here, the addition is 14. So, the degree of the polynomial is 14. Two terms are equal. And we will substitute these two terms by y. So, we will write x square minus x. Let it be y. Now, we will take this whole example by substituting y in the place of these two terms. So, we will write this example first. And then, we will substitute this. Now, y square minus 8y plus 12. You can see here is a square bracket. That's why we take here y square. And 8 is in multiplication with this, so it will get minus 8y and 12 will be remain as it is. Now, we have to take this example and solve it. So, we have to split this middle term and we have to take two numbers whose multiplication is 12 and addition is minus 8y. So, we will take this at one side and take its factors. So, the two numbers are minus 6y and minus 2y. So, these two terms when multiplied we will get 12 and when added they will get minus 8y. So, we will take these two terms in place of this, minus 8y. So, our new example will be y square minus 6y minus 2y plus 12. Now, we will separate this example and this example to find out the simpler form. So, we have to take a number outside of the bracket to find out the same number inside of the bracket. So, we will take y outside of the bracket and here it will get y minus 6. Y when multiplied to the bracket, it will get y square minus 6y. Now, here we have to take the same terms as here inside the bracket. So, we will take minus 2 and when it is multiplied with this, it will get minus 2y plus 12. So, we have taken these two terms now. Now, we will take this one term at a bracket, a singular bracket and here these two terms at one another bracket. Now, we will substitute this term instead of this term to get our real answer. Now, we will substitute this. Substitute y is equal to x square minus x. Now, we have to take here y. We have to take here y. Now, we will take here x minus x square minus x minus 6. And here, x square minus x minus 2. Now, we have to again split this middle term. You can see here is we have to find out two numbers whose multiplication is 6 and subtraction is x. Here is y x coefficient is not present, so we will take here 1 as its coefficient. Now we will write at one separate corner, right? Now we will take two numbers. So our two numbers are -3 + 2. This number when subtracted will get 1, and when added, when multiplied, will get -6. Now we have to write these two terms at its place. Now we will write x² - 3x + 2x - 6. Now take these two terms and these two terms at one different bracket. But before this, we have to take this and we have to take another two numbers whose multiplication is -2 and subtraction is x. Means what? Now these two numbers, we will also write this at one corner. Now the two numbers are 1 - 2 × 1. This when multiplied will get -2 and when subtracted will get only 1. -1. Now we will write these factors also. x² - 2x + 1x, or we will not write 1 because we don't write, generally we don't write this. Now we will take this. Then we will take these two terms and these two terms at one separate bracket, and these two terms and these two terms at separate bracket with their signs. Now we have to again take a number outside of the bracket to find the same number inside of the bracket in both the expressions. Now we will take x out of the bracket, so we will get x - 3, and here we will take 2, so we will get x - 3. You can see this, both two terms inside the bracket are same. And now we will just same as this, we will do this. Now we will take x outside of the bracket to get x - 2 inside of the bracket. Here we will take 1 outside of the bracket to get this same term inside of the bracket. Now we will take these two terms and we will write it once, so they will get x - 3, and these two terms outside of the bracket we will write as 1. So our first equation gives us x - 3 and x + 2. Our second equation gives us x - 2 + x + 1. Now we have to verify this and check that our following answers are right or wrong. So we will put the value of x. Now x here is equal to -3 = 0. So when we will put this 3 to the left hand, to the right hand side, it will get +3. So x is equal to 3. Now same as this, we will take x + 2, and when it will go to this side, it will get minus. So our x value is 2 - 1 = 0, and when this will go to this side, it will get plus. So it will get x = 2 only. Now x + 1 = 0. Now this +1 will get -1, and it will give x = -1. Now we have to verify it again. So when we will put the value of x, so x value was 3, and we have to find out the value, so it is also 3. So you can see it is verified because there are same values. Now again this one, now we will put the value of x, then we will put the value we find, is equal to -2. Then again with the second expression, now x value was 2, so 2 is equal to 2, and second 2 - 1.